anybody hear me out in these streets?
Welcome to another edition of Exciting Panther Sports, ladies and gentlemen. We're live here in the William Nix Center, Charles Porter, along with the big dog, our boss, Anton Dolph, ladies and gentlemen. AD, welcome to the show, man. It's a first for basketball, man. We were pretty popular on the volleyball game, so I'm really excited about today, man. Thanks for stopping by and joining us.
No problem.
This is really starting, man, to be something wonderful, man. It's, folks, if you hadn't came by and you hadn't watched any of the games, you hadn't even come on campus to see what's going on, you're really missing it. The game day atmosphere is completely different.
Absolutely. We're trying to make sure that our students, our season ticket holders, any new guests that come have a great experience and want to come back. That's the big thing. We want them to come back.
Well, you invested a lot of money in trying to promote our games and start getting our streams back together. A lot of people are starting to watch now. We almost doubled our numbers on Saturday from our previous games. We were really excited about that. Ms. Thurston did a great job of putting the things together to get us to where we are now. She went out and got a top-line production company and Oakland Entertainment. And, man, I think the people are really going to be pleased with what they see down the stretch here.
Yeah, people love you, man.
It's
partly you. I get a lot of comments about, you know, my guy Charles Porter, and I appreciate that, man. And, you know, I'm here to support y'all. Like I said, I want us to have a great game day atmosphere, but a lot of people can't make it to the games. We've got Panther fans across the country, around
the
world.
Absolutely.
I want them to be able to be a part of what we're doing, and so this is one of the ways we can do that.
Mm-hmm. You know, we talked about fundraising. You know, it's always talking about money, and money makes the athletic department go round, folks. And we've got to really start to give back to our institution. I've been talking to a lot of basketball players. They've been getting the calls of late who really want to do some things. And they like this atmosphere, the lights going off, the videos that you guys put together for the team. I mean, it's just top-notch. And, man, people are really excited, and they're starting to watch. Baseball season is coming up. Went to the championship last year. Didn't get the win. But, you know, Anton has got a great team out there. We're real excited about him.
Yeah.
Mr. Coach Riggins, Anton Riggins. And then, of course, what do you say about Vernon Bland, who is going to three-peat this year? I mean,
he didn't go recruit.
He reloaded. He's got
Absolutely.
Some really, really bonus players out there, and we're really excited about that. Our track team is coming back, and we're really excited about that. Back-to-back wins and you know, the PB relays are coming. You hadn't had a chance to experience that, so that's going to be a lot of fun for you. We're going to be doing a lot of barbecuing right now. That's going to be fun for you.
I'll be
But there. Anyway, it's going to be a lot of fun as we get this one underway, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers with a big win on Saturday night. I saw you over there cheering. I started to throw you a pom-pom, AD. A three-point win. The Panthers did it down the stretch.
Yeah, it was tight. I mean, you know, we were really great in the first two quarters offensively. Second half, we went a little cold, but our defense brought us through that. We had a scoring drought. I can't remember how long it was. It was at least like 5-6 minutes.
It was a 7-minute scoring drought there coming in between the third and fourth
quarters. Yeah.
We finally got it going with Waddle off the bench. And, of course, Waddle gets the big winning rebound at the end of the game. But, man, she came off the bench and did just extremely well. I've got some stats out here just to talk about some of the players who did a great job. Ryan Payne, the transfer student from LSU, has come in. She's leading the Panthers with 17 points. Amaria Williams, the freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas, Central Arkansas. She's a beast down there. She's just got to gather herself and just be a little more poised. I love her energy. She's got a real, real soft shot. She's real good around the perimeter. And she's a big person out there. She's a big target. And once you get her down there on the block, it's hard to defend.
Absolutely. She's got really nice big girl skills. Ryan, super athletic. I mean, you know, obviously she came from LSU, but the way she can control the tempo of a game is so impressive. Now, I do understand she had a little cut on her finger to kind of mess with her.
I think that was it Desiree or was it Jada? No, it was Michaela Hutchinson.
Ryan Payne. No, she's
Payne?
Ryan Payne. Yeah. Come
her
on.
Fingernail.
I know the inside track.
You know the inside track?
Man, I know some things.
Well, Hutch also pricked her finger. So she was nursing the sore finger, too. But I remember that now because after the game, Payne came over here by the table and pulled up her fingernail.
Yeah,
so
she's
going to have to work and play through
she's
some
have to
pain.
Work through that.
We're going to try to quickly get these starters here. We know for Prairie View A&M University who is going to be starting. The guards are Ryan Payne, who is thank you, sir. I was looking for that. Ryan Payne, Jada Bowen, Adriana Waddle, Desiree Lewis, and Amari Williams are going to get the start today. We're going to change up that starting lineup and throw a Waddle in there because she played
so well.
She played so well on the other
day. She earned it. And that's what I like about Coach Pugh. You earn your minutes on that floor.
You know, she's had some challenges out there. Some players have left and went to other places. The portal, you know, got real big this year with some of those players that were able to play right now.
Yep.
And some of those other guys, man, I tell you, swooped up a lot of players from the portal there in the very, very beginning. But she did her homework. She stayed, you know, to her faith and got some players in here that can really make a difference. I mean, I think the biggest find had to be Payne coming out.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, coming from LSU, that absolutely. One of the biggest transfers, I think, in SWAC that came this year, man. So looking forward to continue. She's improved throughout the year, and I'm waiting for when we get down to the SWAC tournament.
Oh, man.
That she's going to really explode.
Well, they do it big in Birmingham. We're really looking forward to go. I've been talking with Woodlawn Entertainment. The Panthers will be there, so I'll be there, and we'll be doing some stuff for the Southwestern Athletic Conference. So we're really, really excited about it. The Panthers tonight need to get a win here. You know, the goal is to be 6-3 leaving. And now the men's team has got to get it together. I think they played well. They just, you know, they just went cold from the field. They missed some big shots, and they missed some big rebounds and some poor plays.
Some free throws. They missed. They didn't shoot really well from the free throw line. And it was, you know, I was excited about how they were playing, how they were in that game, because size-wise, those guys were way bigger than us.
Abaku Aban is huge, folks. So he did it. Look here, folks, we're going to take a quick break here. We're going to stay here or take a break? Gentlemen, the pre-game warm-up, man, y'all spent a lot of money on that video. I need to close my mouth while that video is going on. Man, but that is just, I mean, that is top-notch. That's big time.
Yeah.
And I love it, man. I love it. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, getting the start for the Purdue Panthers at guard, a sophomore from Jada Bowen, a sophomore. Where we go, Charles? I got my cards late. Get it together. Jada Bowen, a sophomore from Crete, Illinois, is also starting at guard, a graduate student from Los Angeles, California, number 10, Ryan Payne. Starting from Fort Worth, Texas, a junior transfer student. We just got to talking about her, Adriana Waddle, who's had a fantastic game. Of course, Desiree Lewis and Amari Williams both taking up the backcourt there, or the forecourt there on the blocks with the forward and the center position. So we're excited about it. We're going to get it going as I can get my sea legs going. And this is going to be a lot of fun.
It's good to see Waddle back healthy.
Yeah,
you know, I know she had a little knee issue, but, you know, see her play the way she did last game, I only expect her to keep improving.
You know, the Panthers had to make some mid-season adjustments. Nyam Thornton, the point guard, didn't come back to the team here in the spring, so that means that Payne had to move over to the point guard position. And Jada Roberson is coming along with Maya Williams. They're coming along, but it's just going to take a little time for them to get in rhythm. And if you watch the post-game show on Saturday, that's exactly what Coach Pugh says. They're a rhythm team, and as long as they're in rhythm, they're all right. But when they get out of sync, they kind of get Harry Carey.
Yeah. And, you know, it's that old saying, next woman up.
Woman up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Alabama A&M's Anaya Simmons is their leading scorer, averaging 14 points per game. Their head coach, Miss Margaret Richards, in her fifth season, of course. Sandy Pugh in her sixth season here at Prairie View A&M University. Should be a good battle. 3-3, coach, taking on 3-3.
Yeah.
Just making sure of the starting lineup. We're going to have number 3, LaCambia Shakespeare, a junior from Atlanta, Georgia. Let's see. Are we going to go with the same starters, Darian Bergen, the senior from Cincinnati, Ohio, along with Amaya Simmons, the junior from Overland Park? The big person down in the middle, is that going to be Norman? Is she going to get the start, or are they going to go with Jayla Cody? Is that a 1 or a 2 there?
I got 11, and I think that's number 2.
That's going to be Lacambia Shakespeare. All right, folks, it's from left to right on your radio dial. If you're listening, if you're watching, it's straight up. Jumping it up, Waddle gets it quickly over the paint, off the glass, an easy there one for go. Two. Globetrotters here in the start. Here we go back with the Bulldogs, the Panthers in the full court press. They throw it away. The Panthers didn't have to work on that press real hard. They threw it away.
Unforced error right there. That was good. They didn't adjust well to the press on that one.
Kayla Turner, the point guard from Orange Park, Florida, lost the ball in the poor pass. 1-3-1 zone. Here come the Panthers. Up top now, left side to give it over to Lewis. Down low, quick one, easy one. Soder's on the baseline. Gets it back out now to Robertson. She puts it up for two. Hits the side of the iron, though. We're going back the other way quickly. Here comes Bergen. Down low, on the left block, puts it off the glass, is Alicia Wilson, too much, out from three-point land. Trying to drain it was Kayla Turner, no good. They'll get the ball back, and here comes Bergen to set it back up with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Left corner, dribble drive, Simmons on the baseline, throws it out of bounds, nope, saved by Kayla Turner. Turner coming right side from 15, puts it off the glass, no, straight in, it's good for two.
It's a good shot there, good D, better offense.
Tied at 2-9-0-3. Left to play here in the early going. Payne will have it and set up the offense for Pugh. Soders going down on the right elbow. Williams on the left elbow. They'll get it to Soders on the right side. Pardon me, that's Lewis. Lewis looking down low. Takes it from 20. In
good
and
rebound.
Out, no good. Waddle with the rebound. Puts it off the glass. No. And comes down to the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M, Alicia Wilson, the junior from Laverne, California. Gets it out. Gets it back on the answer. Puts it off the glass. No. And the Panthers will have it.
Good box out, good rebound right there. Pushing it up, Payne to the hole.
Yeah, great dribble drive. Caught Wilson standing flat-footed. Faked off to the right, went around the block and put it in. Here come the Bulldogs. Simmons gets in the corner, gets in trouble, tries to throw it out and gets it over to Turner.
It's great defense
for a bailout.
Right there.
Turner in trouble. That's traveling. No call. A mad scuffle for it. Jump ball. It's going to stay down here on the Bulldogs' side.
Good hard defense right there. I thought that was a travel, but we'll take the tie-up right there.
8:07 left to play, folks. If you want to watch the live stats, just go to our webpage, www.pvpanthers.com. Just scroll down the middle. Scroll down the middle until you see the game. You'll see it on the right-hand side. Three dots up in the right-hand corner. Click that, and you can hit the live stats with the three arrows on the right side. Here we go. Wilson on the right side looking for Simmons. Can't get it to her. Now kicks it over to Turner. Turner with a dribble by from five. Puts it up. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Beating
the
clock.
Rebound.
And here comes Soder. Soder's on the fast break. Slows it down. Comes right side. Looking down. Lewis wants it. Lewis calling for it. Oh, Soder's can't get it to her. But Lewis had position there.
Unforced
error
right there.
Another turnover.
You've got to get a better entry pass on that one.
Both pulled on the live stats, and you can see that's three turnovers unofficially. We'll see here in just a moment for the Panthers here in the early going. 7:44 left to play here in the first. Nope, that's just only, well, they're not counting it as a turnover. There it is, one turnover for the Panthers. They'll count that one. Two turnovers in the game. Right side with it. Bergen has it up top, takes it to the elbow from five. Now puts it on the left side, and Shakespeare will drain it for two. Tied at four. 7:22 left to play in the first. Roberson gets it back now over to Lewis. And Lewis will fight through Kayla Turner. Turner's got her in trouble. And she gets it over now to Roberson. Roberson's got to do it. Here she goes. Dribble drive off the left-hand side. With the left hand, she'll be fouled.
Aggressive play right there. We've now got to break the press. They put a press on us. We had a little trouble with that, but that was aggressive play going to the hole.
Good dribble drive. Checking in now for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M, Victoria Dixon, a sophomore from Grand Prairie, Texas, off the bench for the Panthers. Here she comes, Geraldine Smith, the difference maker from Miramar, Florida.
Very athletic, very long.
Roberson at the three-point line for the Panthers. At the free throw line for the Panthers. First shot is away. It is good. The Panthers shooting pretty good from the charity stripe. 73. I talked to Coach earlier. She said we want to be shooting around 85, 84, 85%.
Yeah, we got to get up to the mid-80s.
73 is not bad, though.
But we're
not bad.
It's
a little below average. We want to do better, of course.
We want to be better.
But if you look at the pairings in the Southwestern Athletic Conference, only one team shooting 84%, and that's Texas Southern. And the dribble drive coming out from Turner.
Oh, it's a coast-to-coast right there. We got to play a little bit better D. They got the press back on us again. We got to break it. Oh, here we go.
Here comes Roberson across the timeline, looking down low, Waddle calling for it. Now they'll kick it back up top now and save it. with Payne. Soders wants it. They give it over to Smith from the left elbow. That's her shot. Off the glass, no good.
Little long.
Here we come back with Victoria Dixon. Dixon on the left side throws it down low. A traveling violation, no call. Wilson kicks it back up there to Shakespeare, and Shakespeare will pull it out and give the Bulldogs some breath here. Bergen at the top of the key, left side wing. Mass substitutions for the Panthers. Here's Wilson, kicks it back outside, left side. Wilson for three, no.
Good rebound.
Waddle with a long rebound, and here we go back the other way with
Good,
Robertson.
Strong rebound right there. That's what you needed. Get a stop.
Roberson at the top of the key. Hutchinson getting ready to check in for the Panthers. I think that's Bowen on the line, or either Caleb Smith. Smith, right corner. Roberson thinking about the three-pointer. Now brings it left wing. Finds a hole. Puts it up on 15.
That's a foul.
Hits
yeah.
it on her arm. Yes, she'll go to the line for two.
Grab your arm on the way up. That was a good aggressive move.
Checking in for the Bulldogs will be Chanel Mitchell, a senior from Austin, Texas, right down the street. Bowen will check in. And Amari Williams will check in. Not the starters that are on the pregame here. She kind of mixed it up.
I love how deep our bench is.
Oh, absolutely. We had 17 bench points on Saturday, so they did well off the bench. 6-6 the score. Panthers, folks, if you didn't know, defeated the Hornets of Alabama State, 46-43 right here before a packed crowd here in the William Nix Center, man.
Absolutely.
Kudos to the students.
Great crowd.
Folks, if you're listening, call your kids and tell them to get to that game. Support your Panthers.
Well, and just to talk about the bench again, I love the fact that our bench is deep, and now that's going to help us going down the stretch to state. Oh, that was close.
Absolutely. Almost good steal by Williams. Went for it. Got caught. And an easy bucket from Wilson.
Yeah, she just missed by a smidgen. Another
Here
press
comes
break.
Bowen. Left side wide open. Hutchinson. Boom. Let's do it from New Orleans, Louisiana.
That's how you break a press.
Want to send a shout out over there to Algiers and the Hutchinson family. They're listening. Hutchinson with some good defense. Back over on Victoria Dixon, and they'll set it up. The Panthers up 1-9-8 over the Bulldogs. Dixon coming left side, throws it down low, gets it over to Adam Mitchell with a twist and turn. Good feed Ooh. In the middle. And a foul by Smith. Is they going to get that one to Smith or Williams? Both of them in the same vicinity. What number?
Two
shots. Three? What would they give it to? Three?
Yeah, I think they gave it to two, maybe.
Well, it'll be Bowen if that's the case. At the line, shooting free throws is going to be Alicia Wilson. Wilson not all that happy from the free throw line. 51%, 18 of 35.
She made that
into
one,
line,
though.
I couldn't get it out quick enough to
yeah,
jinx
you,
her.
Yeah, you need to get it out early so you can jinx her.
The Bulldogs, 70% of the team shooting free throws. They average about 11 free throws per game. So that's one. We'll keep them, try to cut them down to 9 tonight.
Absolutely.
5:02 left to play. Ladies and gentlemen, Charles Porter, Anton Goff coming to you live from the William Nix Center on the beautiful campus of Prairie View A&M University. So excited to be here. Thank you for watching. Share. Tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10 about exciting Panther sports on the Prairie View A&M University YouTube channel. Great job by Ms. Thurston getting all of this stuff put together.
Absolutely. She's one of the best that's ever done it.
Here we go. Right side, Payne with a nice layup off the glass. It's good.
Love her game. So smooth, effortlessly.
11-10, a one-point edge.
Now we put there you go. See, a pressing team doesn't like to be pressed.
No.
And so we
Absolutely.
Just put press on them and cause a turnover.
Yeah, the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M with a big turnover ratio, averaging 16.4 turnovers per game, ladies and gentlemen. Media timeout on the court. We'll take a break, folks. Don't forget, come back. More exciting Panther basketball is coming your way here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Goff. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter and Anton Goff coming to you live courtside, man, the Panthers. Look at this, the disparity in the shooting percentages. There is none. 4 of 8 for 4 of 8. Doing a great job. What about those turnovers and the points in the paint, Coach? They seem like they're doing a pretty good job there.
Yeah, I mean, you got A&M, they got 6 in the paint, and PV's got 6. So, I mean, this is why the game is 11-10.
The bigs are battling. Hutchinson with a quick one up off the glass. No good. Snatched down by Simmons, and here come the Bulldogs.
Got to make our layups.
On the right. Oh, good defense. Good hand by Jada Bowen. Knocked it off her. Bowen knocked it off of her leg. And the Panthers will get it. That'll be another turnover for the Bulldogs. 2-1 in the turnovers. They're going to give it to.
You're going to give it to the Bulldogs.
Robertson will come out and give Payne a well-deserved breather here on the defensive side. Don't want to get Payne in any foul trouble. Nobody blocking out that time. Just an easy bucket off the left block there from Shakespeare, the junior from Atlanta, Georgia. 12-11, the Bulldogs up by one.
That's too easy right there.
Bowen, right side, gives it over. Now to Smith, back over to Hutchinson, right side now to Bowen, looking down low, trying to get it to Williams. Hutchinson brings it left side now. Roberson trying to run the baseline.
She's got to repost.
Here comes Hutchinson, wide open now. Three-pointer from Williams, looks good. Hits the front of the iron, bounces out. Williams can't shoot the three-point shot, so we didn't all jump out of our seats when she attempted that three-point.
I thought it was going down.
Three-point shot. For those of you who are watching on our other entities, don't forget, stick with our webpage, www.youtube.com, the Prairie View A&M University athletics page. You can catch all the play-by-play and action. Smith with a jumper from the free throw line, no good, coming down with it.
A little strong on that shot. We need to stop right here. Oh,
Mitchell,
somebody's got to stop the
one.
Ball.
Yeah, nobody got in front of her. Coast to coast, Burgeon just went straight down the right-hand side, right around Hutchinson. She got her from behind. That's a silly foul. She just should have held back on that one. And that's going to be 2 team fouls for the Panthers. A couple of more will be in the bonus. Soders will come back.
Transition D is important here.
Absolutely.
Like you have to stop the ball if you want to make it tough on them.
Bergen will be at the charity stripe for free throws. Bergen completes the three-point play, 15-11. 3-3, playing 3-3. It's going to be a battle down to the wire here. Bowen at the top of the key. Dixon. D'ing her up to get it left side now. Over to Smith. She'll back it out. Give it to Soders for a quick jumper right inside the three-point line. Hits the front of the iron. No good. Waddle snatches it, and a foul away from the ball. Nope, a foul.
On number 2 on A&M.
Yeah, that one's going to be on the floor there. No shooting foul. And Lewis will come back in and give Smith a break. Smith. That's who nicked her finger. That's who I was trying to say, along with Payne. So we got two brokey fingies there on our bench. Here we go, right side. Waddle now kicks it out. Soders has to chase it down. Slows it down. Gets it over to Robertson. Now back to Bowen. Up off the bench is Payne. Left side, Soders looking down low. Soders steps back. Now finds Robertson. Now to Bowen with the dribble drive. Kicks it back left side. Lewis with it. Yeah, no. In and out.
Rebound.
Bowen with a good rebound. Matt Scuffle traveling. Jump ball. The Panthers should have it.
It's tough. We need a score. We are haven't scored in a couple minutes here.
The Panthers. Let me pop back over here to the live stats. The Panthers. Uh-oh. The Panthers are 0-5 in their last field goal attempts.
Yeah. A little cold right now. Somebody needs to get this scoring drought over with.
Well, they got Payne in here, so Payne, yeah. It shouldn't be long now.
She's got to be aggressive.
Lewis back over to Roberson on the right corner. Roberson looking inside, gives it back over now to Lewis. Lewis with the dribble drive, loses it, tries to get it back, and we're going back the other way. That's another turnover, wide open. Here comes Simmons.
Good defense.
Blocked out of there.
Great block.
Roberson with the get on out of here.
Great block. Way to not give up on the play right there.
Simmons with a good dribble drive. Man, she got all ball. Okay, there
Absolutely.
We go.
That was clean.
Fresh 26 on the shot clock. Simmons drilling it down. Roberson almost got it. Simmons with a running hook puts it up off the glass, and they're going to give it to Waddle. Waddle says, yeah, coach, that's my bad. I got her on the brokey fingy. 2:39 left to play here in the first. Ladies and gentlemen, fast and furious action in the William Nick Center. Charles Porter, along with Anton Goff and Mia Greer, the Panther Sports broadcast team for right now, along with my friends from Oaklawn Entertainment. Oaklawn. Oh, I'm sorry. Oak Bridge. My bad. Oak Bridge. My what? Woodlawn. Did I say Oaklawn? I'm sorry. Oak is a wood, and that's what you get for look. That's what you get for talking about barbecue earlier. You know I barbecue with Oak Woodlawn, folks, out of Woodlawn, Mississippi, as in Woodville, Mississippi. I got it. Never mind. Yeah, I don't need a card. I've got several. 2:33 left to play. We're going back the other way. 16-11. Roberson. Right side, right wing, wide open. Lewis.
Oh,
Lewis picked up some Samsonite.
Yeah.
She
definitely traveled.
Coach, did you ever own a set of Samsonite Woodlawn Entertainment? I got you.
W-E, Woodlawn Entertainment.
W-E,
man.
And we're not talking about W-W-E.
Nah, just W-E.
Just one W.
We.
One W and a E. He's going to dock my pay there. That's okay. 26 seconds on the shot clock. Back up top, Simmons will have it. Looking left side. Gives it up to Turner. Turner wants to work on Payne. Tries to go around the pick. Does. Set by Mitchell. Here comes Turner now. Loses it.
There
she
got him. Yeah,
now,
I saw that.
Okay, now, I don't know what neighborhood you're from. What would you call that on the sandbox?
That's a carry.
Carrying.
That's a carry.
I kind of like this guy.
That's a carry all day.
Carry it.
Yeah.
2:05 left to play. You know, it's something when people have their own jackets with their logo on it. You say, look at this jacket, man. Woodlawn. Stay away from that oak tree. Here we go, left side. Oh, Payne with a nasty move there at the baseline. Yeah, right there.
That's a great one-on-one effort. We got to get back on Dito. Look at that.
Hold on, folks. Here we go. Okay, so we're going to just make sure that we get it right. But, oh, man, what a face job there by Ryan Payne, ladies and gentlemen, as she goes coast to coast with some great defense for the Panthers. And, man, I'm telling you, it's going to be fast and furious all the way down the stretch.
Listen, we've got to play some D, man. At the end of the day, transition D is going to make sure we win this game.
Media timeout until the 30. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll stay here doing this one. AD, we're getting ready for the National Signing Day.
Absolutely.
And we are excited about National Signing Day. They're going to throw the graphic up. The Southside Sporting Club.
There you go.
1110 1110 West Airport in Stafford, Texas. Co-hosted by Prairie View A&M University's Alumni Affairs. 7 p.m. Prepaid admission, $30. You can go online at https://, and the rest of that. Just look at the at the graphic. You can also go to our webpage, www.pbpanthers.com, and go to our marketplace, and you can find tickets there.
Yeah, we're excited about it. I mean, you unveiling our newest addition to our football team, and then, you know, have a little fun afterwards and make sure we reveal the rest of this season.
We'll talk about the schedule and also season tickets coming up. We're going on a campaign early. We want you to buy season tickets. We're trying to sell 2,000 season tickets. Here we go, down low, looking for Lewis. Lewis puts it up off
there
the glass.
There you go. Yeah.
Wendell gather herself, really heads up play.
Yeah.
Good job of being poised. Here
that
comes
was
the Panthers with the
right
press.
There. She
Mitchell
fought through it.
Throws it on the left side. Burgeon gets it across.
The
breaks the press. Good job by Roberson. Ooh, getting in the middle. Face job, 0-0. Hey. 00. Wow. That's a good one.
Got to stop the ball.
Down 5, 2015 here with a minute left to play in the first quarter. Smith at the top of the key. Looking for Soders, gets it to her on the left wing. She spins, gets it on the baseline. Down low, great pass into the hands of the opponents. Alicia Wilson trying to get it over to Smith coming around the other side, but couldn't. Here come the Bulldogs. Good move by Mitchell, and she's going to be fouled by Soders.
That was another unforced error. I don't know which.
No, they're
going to
get that
there.
One with Smith. Smith's going to come over and be called for that one. Soders was right there. They'll get Smith out.
Got to play with a little bit more composure there. We cannot let their defense rush us into unforced errors.
That's going to be the first. That's the first on Smith. Okay. The Panthers now with 14 fouls. Shot is away. It's good. We talked about free throws, extend leads, coach, and win games.
Absolutely.
70% free throw shooters are the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Mitchell, 57%, sets me up very quickly with that second shot.
Yeah, you said they weren't good free throw shooters.
Well,
I don't
70%,
think,
you know, we talked about them being 84%, but they're hitting them tonight.
Yeah. Maybe they'll miss them in the second, third, and fourth quarter.
Sending shouts out to Xavier and Bryson. They're listening. All excited about it. Williams down low. Now, see, there you go. Lewis got, Williams that time got Mitchell on her hip. That's where you want her.
When she gets positioned, it's hard to defend her.
Absolutely.
When she gets positioned, it's hard to defend her. She's a skilled big man.
14 fouls on the Bulldogs. One more win. A penalty. Quick pass on the inside. It's knocked away. Williams can't hold on to it. Wide open. Mitchell coming down the left side. Simmons, rather, puts it off the glass for two.
Got to hold on
to
the ball.
Transition.
Got to hold on to the ball.
Payne, the transfer from LSU, elected to keep the same colors. Goes left side on the baseline. It's going to be a blocking foul. Didn't have both feet planted that time. Good job of penetrating there by Payne. And Payne gets up rather gingerly.
Yeah, that was an aggressive move right there.
Mitchell is playing some good defense out there. Mitchell's really, really, really quick for the Bulldogs. Got over, and did she get flagged with a foul? Was it Mitchell 11, or did they give that one to Wilson? Some reason we can – let's look at the live stats here. Didn't say here. At the line, should be at the line here. I got a new stat program. Man, this is really good. It's just got here. It's got so much you can't figure out where it's all. The largest run, 2-0 substitution long. Payne. Payne 4-4 from the field. Now one of
there
one.
There we go once again.
From the charity stripe. Those quick guards are giving Panthers fits. As time expires here in the first quarter, it's been really good, ladies and gentlemen. Just a little warm, folks. The Panthers are heating up here. 24-17, the Panthers have got to get something done down by seven here going into the second quarter. Stick around. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
Hey, Dawn, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter now coming solo. Anton Goff, our athletic director, did a pretty darn good job. Did a good job, Woodlawn Entertainment. We're going to make sure we don't mess that one up anymore. Boy, I tell you, I felt the heat all the way over here on the left side. 9:53 left to play here in the first. Here comes Simmons on the right side. Gives it up to Turner now on the right wing. Turner thought about it. Now gives it back out. Pushes it back out quick to Simmons. Sills, dribble drive on the elbow. In trouble. Puts it up. It's going to roll in for her. Oh, wow. 9:34 left to play. Want to sincerely thank Raymond Holly, my classmate, G-Boom, Phi Beta Sigma, KK Psi, veteran, former firefighter, former police officer, former assistant. No, I'm just teasing. Everybody knows G-Boom. He's helping me get my stuff together. Thank him a lot. On the right side with it, Smith down low, looking, trying to get it to Williams, man. Bad pass. We've got to watch our passes going in on the inside. Here we go, right side with Turner again. Thought about the dribble drive over to Wilson. Now down low and throwing it away. That time was Chanel Mitchell, the senior from Austin, Texas, committing the turnover. Waddle and Smith will check in along with Shakespeare for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Shakespeare towering at 6'4". Waddle at 6'3 and 3 quarters. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. 8:58 left to play. Quick inbounds pass. Nobody blocking. Simmons out. Golly gee, Waddle's got to get over there and give Williams a little help there coming off of that pick. 28-17, Lady Panthers having it rough. We got to get back in rhythm here. Back up top. Here comes Smith for two. Front of the iron, no. Waddle can't snatch down the long rebound, and we're going back the other way. Left side with it. Turner misses it, loses the handle, now gets it back up over to Wilson. Wilson right hand, no. Wilson picks up some American Tourister, and she's traveling. Here comes Jada Bowen to give Williams a breather with 8:26 left to play here in the first. The Panthers having it rough, down by 11, folks. Trying to get back up in it. Pewitt, center court, trying to bark out some instructions. Smith, there she goes. Smith with a double pump. That's what we want. Smith with the dribble drive off the left-hand side. It's very, very hard to dribble because she shoots it up with, I mean, pardon me, to defend, because she dribbles with her left hand. Here comes right side. Ooh, Turner with some good moves. Puts it up. Hits the front of the iron. No good. Using her strength and her height is Shakespeare, who takes it away, puts it back up, and one to keep the Bulldogs at 11, keeping the Panthers at bay. Wow. Alabama A&M giving the Panthers the business on the in the paint there. 16-10, Alabama A&M with 3 second chance points and 7 points off fast breaks. We got to do better to keep them in control here. Shakespeare will shoot one. Shot is away, and it's going to creep in. Man, everything is falling for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Lewis has it, left elbow, brings it around the right side, picks up her dribble, gets it out to Payne. Payne trying to find an opening, good defense by Turner. Payne with the crossover, brings it over the left side. She's got that fadeaway on the baseline is Williams. Yeah, with a strong one off the glass, too strong. And it's in and out, Smith rather. In and out, too strong. Turner, Wilson, Bergen. Left side to the right to Simmons. Simmons brings it left, throws it in the corner, trying to find Wilson, and she throws it away. Here comes Roberson for Smith. And the Panthers now faced with the Bulldogs with 10 seconds. Oh, great hand that time by Waddle. They steal it away. Good pass there on the right side to Payne. Off the glass, Payne is hammered. Great pass that time by Jada Bowen, man. Trying to go for the assist. Good pass there. Just too much. Off the bench for the Bulldogs is going to be Chanel Mitchell from Austin, Texas. I'm sure she's got some family here. Austin a couple of hours away from Prairie View A&M and the Panthers. Nope, there is a media timeout here on the court, ladies and gentlemen. 7:09 left to play here in the second quarter. 31-19 to score. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word. It's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Ladies and gentlemen, for up-to-the-minute coverage on exciting Panther sports, visit our website at www.pvpanthers.com. You can also visit us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and X at PVAMU. Or just visit our webpage, www.pvpanthers.com. We'll give you all the information, all of the scheduling, our Facebook and Twitter posts. You can drop down, and if you didn't watch the game, you can always go back to our YouTube page and watch it as many times as you like. Payne's second shot is away. Now the Panthers down 10 with a little work to do. Full court press. Our trap put in a press now by the Panthers. Now we're coming over the right side with an easy one from Bergen. And a steal there by Roberson. Roberson, coast to coast, cuts it to 8. Chip it a little bit at a time. Simmons across the timeline with some good ball handling. The trap there. They're trapping Simmons. Simmons and a jump ball, and the Panthers get it back. Great defense by the Panthers. Good trapping, pressing defense by the Panthers. All started by the steal from Robertson. That wasn't real you-know-ish. That was kind of like, you know, we need we need some loud, no. That's what we need, folks. Here we go, left side, Bowen to Lewis, back over now to Payne. Payne trying to get Bowen on the curl. Bowen back out to Payne. Thought about the three-pointer. Gets a birdie. Now puts it, oh, wait, good move. Gets up in the air, has it partially blocked. And the Panthers keep it on their side. Yeah, good defense that time by the Bulldogs, but the Panthers keep a handle on it. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Here we go. Waddle with a turnaround 15-footer. Hits the back of the iron, no good. Roberson can't control it, and here come the Panthers. Simmons now, left side, around the back, puts it up. Oh, great block by Waddle. Simmons gets it back, gets it on the baseline, loses it. Oh, and it's knocked out of bounds by Soders. No, the other official says it's coming back the other way. Yeah, switch that one over, Mr. Referee. The Panthers will get it back. 6:05 left to play. The Panthers are on a run here. Prairie View on a 4-0 run, their longest run of the contest. Lewis, elbow. Backing it out, looking for Payne. Payne will get it now at the top of the key. Steps back, looking left side. Waddle wants it, down to 10 seconds. Here comes Payne with the no look. Goes around the back with a double pump. Puts it up, hits the side of the iron, no good. Coming down with it. And going back the other way now is Shakespeare. To be or not to be, blocked by Bowen. Wow. Now the Panthers have the Bulldogs a little rattled. The Panthers on a 4-0 run with 5:31 left to play here in the first half, 31-23. The Bulldogs on top. Turner all the way up, gets it out now there to Dixon. Mitchell at the top of the key, back over to Bergen. Bergen loses it, Soders with it. Gives it to Robeson, Bergen gets it back. Some good heads up playing by the Bulldogs. Here we go, back right side. Bergen will step back out and attack Jada Robeson. Robeson with the defense coming left wing. Bergen found a spin move. Robeson comes back over there with the complimenting defense and knocks it out of bounds. 5 minutes left to play here in the second. Quick pass inside to Turner. Turner at the top of the key, bringing it left, working on Payne. Goes left, now takes it right, gets a birdie, puts it up. Almost in, no. Waddle down with the rebound. Here we go back the other way with Bowen. Bowen. Looking right side, over to Smith, bad lazy pass. Owen Bowen with the foul. Golly geez, lazy pass. We've got to be careful with those. The Bulldogs are pretty quick. Averaging 8.2 steals per game, third in the conference, pretty good. Got to be careful with those passing lanes and get those passes sharp and crisp. Soders. We'll check in for Bowen to kind of settle it down. Here we go, left side now with Bergen. Bergen back up top now, gives it over to Dixon, down to Shakespeare, and a personal foul against Shakespeare. Shakespeare will pick up her second. And that's going to be the second team foul for the Bulldogs. The Panthers need a couple of more to get in the bowling bonus. Jayla Cody, a senior from Valdosta, Georgia, will check in. She's 6'1". A lot of good height. Well, good height. A lot of height. I know that was a trip, wasn't it? A lot of height there for the Bulldogs. Roberson. Bringing around the right side. Zero working on zero. Robeson working on Bergen. Now Payne has it. Wide open for three. Looked good. No. Soders. Oh, almost had the rebound. Couldn't control it. Almost is only in checkers. Here we go right side. Dixon stops. Simmons for three. Waddle with the re. Now Robeson will bring it up right side. And slow it down to 3:44 left to play here in the first half. Crossover, Robertson now bringing it by the elbow, back up top to Waddle. Waddle looking left side, trying to get it into Payne. Now back to Lewis, to Soders on the dribble drive. Waddle with the rebound, putting it back up, yeah, it's good. Great position that time by Waddle, 3:21, and here we come. Simmons on it with the left side, back up top now, gives it to Cody. Cody back up left side. Dixon will take it now back over to Bergen. Bergen, Mitchell. Mitchell brings around the curl, looking on the corner, trying to get it over. Now she does to Dixon for three. No. Here come the Panthers on the fast break right now. Payne with it, with a reverse layup off the glass. Yeah, man. Baby, I love it. Beautiful, baby. And the Bulldogs say, the Panthers are within four. And the Baby Dome is on fire. Well, folks, media timeout. We're going to stretch it out. Yeah, we'll stretch it out to a media timeout, ladies and gentlemen, and take a break with them, folks. The Panthers are battling back 31-27 here in the William Nix Center in the first half. Stick around. We'll take a break and come back with more exciting Panther basketball.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech.
Thank AD Anton Golf for coming out and hanging out with us the first half. Did a pretty good job with some color commentary. Let's take this show on the road, baby. Here we go back right side now with Mitchell. Mitchell coming near the elbow, kicks it back out to Bergen. Bergen back to, oh, thoughts about going into Mitchell. She loses it. Oh, they call a foul on Roberson. Oh, come on, ref. Roberson gets her on the floor. The Panthers now with four fouls. One more, we're in the bonus. Out right side now to Turner. Turner brings it left. Now gets it back into the hands of Simmons. Simmons to Bergen. Roberson going for the steal. Left her open. She burns her for it. 33-27, a six-point lead. The Panthers need a score here. Roberson right side. Soders, pardon me, Lewis setting the pick. Waddle will have it at the top. Soders now from the wing back out. Now to Payne, the pick set by Waddle. She's calling for it. Waddle gets it down low on the block. A push on the baseline there, and Cody will be called for the foul. The inlet pass into Waddle. She's calling for it. Waddle, man, has been just playing great off the bench. A minute 50 left to play. 27-33 the score. Here comes Hutchinson. Quick pass inside. Oh, off the glass. Roberson going way high in the land of the Giants to put it back. Nobody blocked her out. Great heads-up play by the Panthers. Jayla Roberson, the graduate student, doing it all for the Panthers from Indianapolis, Indiana. Another steal. Here comes Payne. Payne with an easy one. The Panthers are coming back in this one, folks. Down by two. 33-31. Great play here in the William Nix Center. The Panthers are on fire. On an 8-0 run here in the second quarter. Simmons with the Euro step. In and out, no good. Mitchell puts it back up. She's hammered from behind by Waddle. And it'll stay down here on the Panthers' side. No, wait a minute. They say 32. That's going to go against Lewis. Waddle was right there, but they give it to Lewis. And Hutchinson will check in along with Clamisha Prackett, a freshman from West Memphis, Arkansas. Pardon me. That's LaFredra Green. The junior from Monroe, Louisiana. My bad. LaFredra Green. The junior from Monroe. That's LaFredra. Mitchell at the line. Shot is away. It's good. I tell you, we talked about the free throw shooting percentage at 70%, but the Bulldogs pretty darn good tonight. Seven of eight shooting. Now 8 of 9, the Bulldogs shooting 88% from the charity stripe. Wow. 103 left to play, 35-33 the score. Hutchinson has it on the right side. Kicks it back up left, goes to Waddle now over to Payne. Payne thought about it. Oh, takes it from 20. Gotcha. Payne with the 20-footer, cuts it to two. 42 seconds left to play in this one. Looking for Cody in the middle. Out to Bergen on the dribble drive. She travels, no call. They kick it back out to William Mitchell, rather. Is that Simmons? No, Simmons there out on the right side. Soders almost has it knocked away. Good pass out to Payne. Right side to Hutchinson with the Euro step. Has it blocked. Back out to Payne for the three-pointer. She sets. Pow! Booyah! And the Panthers go up by one with 10 seconds left to play. 36-35. What a first half. Here we go, right side. Bergen puts it up from three-point range. Whoa! Man, the answer. Wow. 38-36, man. Right back at you, Panthers. And, man, what an exciting first half here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 38-36 the score. Man, this is going to be a good one, worth the price of a ticket. Stay tuned, folks. It's halftime in the William Nix Center. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream. All hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool your school. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
We won't bring the music back when we come back. It kind of throws us off a little bit. Well, folks, Fast and Furious action, man. What an exciting first half, ladies and gentlemen. Down to the wire, Roberson played great, but Bergen came down and hit the big three-pointer to put the Bulldogs up by two after the Panthers had come off of an 8-0 run. Big shot by Ryan Payne with a nice, beautiful, easy, sweet three-pointer. But the Panthers didn't get back on defense in time. And the Bulldogs went up by two. But, man, this has been a great game, man. In the paint, it's been a furious battle, ladies and gentlemen. 22 points to 22 points. It was 16-7 in the early going. But the Panthers came battling back, man. And the rebounds are 15 rebounds to 14. Adriana Waddle leading all rebounders with five. And Alicia Wilson with four boards for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Aisha Wilson doing well, 2 of 2 from the free throw range. The Bulldogs in the first half, 9 of 10. The Panthers, 7 of 8. 87% from the free throw line for the Prairie View A&M versus the Panthers, and 90% for the Bulldogs. Some great free throw shooting, only about 4 free throws missed all contests by both teams. So, folks, I tell you, this is a hot and furious one. 10 minutes on the clock, 38-36. Here come the Panthers. And the Panthers getting set for defense on the Bulldog. Bergen throws it down low. Knocked her all out of bounds. The Panthers now. And it's going to be the Panthers. Nope, it's the Panthers ball, right? Oh, there you go, Rick Godfrey. There you go. The turnover ratio, the Bulldogs with 10 turnovers, the Panthers with 8. It seems as though the Panthers had way more turnovers, but only 8. Here comes Payne around the right side. Waddle at the top of the key. Waddle to Roberson. Roberson puts it up. No good, and we're going back the other way. Coming down with it for the Bulldogs is that Bergen with the running jumper, puts it off the glass for two. She's killing him. .40-36 to score. Now the Bulldogs up by 4. 3-3, taking on 3-3, folks. Don't forget, exciting Panther basketball continues as the men get ready to take on the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Should be a good one. Bergen loses the ball. Shakespeare picks it up, gets it back into the hands of Bergen. And we bring it right side. Bergen looking down low, trying to find Wilson. She does. Wilson off the glass and a foul on Soders from behind. That's going to be her second personal foul. First team foul for the Panthers. Checking in, Michaela Hutchinson. Hutchinson, the senior from New Orleans, Louisiana. Redshirt senior. I wonder if she could come back one more year. We could really use Hutch. On the line, Alicia Wilson. First shot is away, no good. Wilson from the charity stripe in the first half, 2 of 2. Now, 3 of 4 from the charity stripe. Hutchinson over to Lewis. Lewis coming right side with a spin move at the top of the key off the foot of Simmons. And the Panthers with another turnover up off the bench. Here comes Geraldine Smith. Lewis getting the break. And the Panthers now faced with a 5-point deficit. Bergen on with a high running jumper off the backboard. Snatching down the rebound or picking it up off the ground there was Ryan Payne. And Payne to set the offense. Robertson wants to set the pick. Waddle does. Robertson now with an open look. Kicks it down low. Waddle looking for Waddle. She wasn't ready for it. And we go back the other way. Bergen up top. Shakespeare has it. Kicks it down low. Wilson, the intended receiver from behind, though. Smith knocks it away. 7:49 left to play in the third. End of the pass over to Wilson. Wilson turning, twisting. On the block, turns it up, puts it up, off the glass, no. Here comes Payne. Payne over on the streaking Smith and a foul on Smith. Or did they just say it went out of bounds? LaFredra Green will check in for the Panthers. And is Waddle going to get a breather? Yeah, Waddle will get a breather. Williams still on the bench. Roberson all the way up top to Payne. 22 seconds, plenty of time on the shot clock. Payne will work from the right. Kicks it back left over to Hutchinson on the dribble drive on the right side. Hutchinson on the drive, off the glass, high archer, no. Waddle fighting for it, but she can't get it, and Bergen will pick it up. Trapped in the corner, they get it out to Shakespeare. Now right side over to Turner. Turner from the free throw line, it's good. Payne working right side. Hutchinson thinking about the three, gives it up now to Green. Green left wing, thought about it, scoops it in. Payne has to chase it down on a bad pass from Green, and here comes Wilson to slow it down into the hands. Now up Simmons. Simmons trapped. Oh, and Payne stops the action and can't stop in time and runs into the back of Kayla Turner. Up off the bench, just mentioned Williams. .43-36, the score. Coming left is Turner. Turner at the top of the key, turns, spins, passes down low on the block, and Bowen ties it up with Wilson. And it should, what, stay on this side of the ball, or is it a Prairie View Panther ball? It's a Prairie View Panther ball. Wilson couldn't get it away from Bowen. And we go back the other way. Bowen coming right side. Slips it. Right side to Payne. Payne on the dribble drive. Double pumps. Hits it off the glass. And charging violation. Called on Payne. And that's going to be two on Payne. Four on the Panthers. One more in there in the bonus here. Bergen kicks it left side over now to Mitchell. Back up top to Bergen, who hit the big three-pointer. Simmons for three. No. Turner steps on the line, and it'll go back the other way. Here comes Smith for Hutchinson. And Green will toss it in now to Bowen. Bowen brings it right side and wants to get it to Payne. Payne comes. Green sets the pick. Payne has it knocked away, chases it back down. Turns, twists, gets it back over to Williams, who snuck in on me. Williams coming left side into the hands of Bowen. They're trying to get Williams on the block. They do. Williams turns around, but Williams turns, hits it off the glass, and a foul on Alicia Wilson. That's the play they want to go to. They want to get their bigs involved, and Williams is handling, well, was handling Wilson down, and now they're going to bring Shakespeare in to counter Williams. Payne with a quick step out to Green. Green throws it in, trying to get it to Williams, throws it away. Here comes Turner. Crosses over, in trouble. Bowen steals it away, saves it. Smith with it over the frame to Green. Good defense, Green. Throws it out, gets it out to Payne for three. Looks good. No good. Mitchell comes down with it, brings it left side, and is immediately trapped. They knock it away. Somebody should have been there to get it. Bergen brings it left side. Here comes Lewis off the bench. 43-36. Panthers down seven. Bergen bringing it around the right side. Takes it to the corner now. Into the hands of Mitchell on the dribble drive. Mitchell with a double pump. Puts it up off the left side of the air. No good. Williams gets it down, and we're going back the other way with Payne. Payne stopping, spotting, free throw, puts it up, no. 4:26 left in the third, folks. Kalen Nash from Muskogee, Michigan, getting ready to check in. Simmons brings it right side. Turner thought about it, goes around Payne, puts it up and under, and she'll be fouled. Roberson will now check in for the Panthers, and they're going to clear this one and call it a media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. 4:01 left to play here in the third quarter. The Panthers are down by a score of 43-36. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gall. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
can drop a hint too, Don.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. I want to send a shout out again to my good friends at Woodlawn Entertainment. We're not going to talk about any oak trees, so I'm not barbecuing with any oak from now on. How about that? Won't be any oak from now on. I'm just going to stick with mesquite. Well, that red oak is just good barbecue wood. I might have to go back. On the line, shooting free throws, Turner misses the first. Second free throw is away, and she'll can that one. Dixon will check back in for the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Ryan Payne leading all scores with 21 points. Roberson takes it baseline and a blocking foul on Mitchell. That's going to be her second personal foul. And finally, coming. Can't see. Okay, here we go. Bowen now at the left elbow. Bowen looking right. Over to Roberson. And looking down back low to Roberson. And it's knocked away. .335 left to play here in the third. She's the other young lady I was telling you about. There we go. All right, left corner. Down low, Mitchell, man, you got to stop that. Williams trying not to get a foul, just kind of stood there with the turnaround and an easy layup for the Panthers, and we've got to stop the ball. AD said it at the beginning of the game. We've got to stop the ball on the defense, man, and we've got to do a better job, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers are with a 30-second timeout. Don't forget, coming up on February 7th at 1110 West Airport, Stafford, Texas. It is National Signing Day. If you need some tickets, go to our website, www.pvpanthers.com. The splash page is there. It'll tell you all the information on how to go ahead and get your pre-sale tickets at $30. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be some auctioning going on, and you'll get a chance to meet the 2024 Panthers. Man, I'm excited about it. Hope to see you there. You're facing the place. That's the National Signing Day for Prairie View A&M University, February 7th. At the Southside Sports Club in Stafford, Texas. Thank you, ma'am. Also, folks, I'm sure season tickets will go on sale that day. Okay, this? What are you talking about? The guys are trying to. Oh, there you go. I'm sorry. 1110 West Airport, Stafford, Texas. If you go to the website, folks, it'll tell you they're pointing at the screen. And I'm like, that screen? No. Idiot, we're talking about the thing. We've got the graphic up for you, Porter. You called early this morning. I was still asleep at 6 o'clock. You're talking about you've been on Bible study and you tried to get the game together. And you had I had you pull the graphic down, and you did. Thank you so much, James. Here comes Smith, left side. Ooh, looks like she picked up a couple of shots. But I mean, a couple of steps, but puts it off the glass for a big shot. 46-38, an 8-point lead. The Panthers cut into it last game. They can do it now. Last half, rather. They can do it now. 3 minutes left to play in the third. Down low. They get it on the baseline, and somebody picked up some Samsonite. Caleb Nash, the junior from Muskogee, Michigan, and we're going back the other way. Bowen throws a soft pass, and Smith, man, has to go for it. Bowen's got to get those passes in quicker. Good defense by Mitchell. That's going to be third on her. And let's see, three team fouls on the Bulldogs. A couple of more, they'll be in the bonus. 2:43 left to play. Checking in for Mitchell is Simmons. Bowen right there. Wide open there is Payne. She kicks it down low to Williams. Williams, oh, can't find the hole. She's got to go up stronger than that. Blocked from behind, and here come the Bulldogs. Simmons. Dixon throws it away. Backcourt, the Panthers to have it. Yeah. Turnover, huge turnover for the Bulldogs. Waddle will come back in for Prairie View. 15 turnovers, two under their average. Are the Bulldogs, they average 17.9 turnovers per contest. Bowen, right side. Back up top, slips it over, and golly gee, now the Panthers turn the ball over. Golly gee, Willikers. Still an 8-point lead, 46-38 to score. Bergen will bring it down on the right side. Here comes Simmons, and a block by Waddle. That's two tonight. Adriana Waddle with a big block for Prairie View. Here comes Soders up off the bench. Roberson with some quality minutes. Mitchell all the way up to Bergen in the corner. Dixon for three. Man, air ball. And we're going back the other way. Bowen. Mitchell said, I'll try the three-pointer. How about Soders? Yeah! Jessica Soders lets it creep in for her. 46-41, the Panthers down five now. Dixon to Bergen. Bergen wants to work on Smith. Smith with some good defense. They're looking down low, trying to get it to Wilson. Crossover. Oh, a strip there by Payne. Went off the leg of Smith, but a great hand by Payne. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Nothing but a catch and shoot. So the Panthers got to play some defense. Keep your hands high. Hands high, hands high. Here we go. The catch and shoot. You got to catch and shoot. Kaylin Nash just can't get around, and Turner is going to come in and get Nash out of there. Or, well, actually Dixon. Dixon, man, with a big air ball. Dixon, pretty good three-point shooter. Shoots 34% from the three-point range. Here comes Bowen Smith under a minute in the third quarter. Payne looking left side. Dribble drive. Gets a birdie. Steps back. Puts it up. Boom! The Panthers now down by three. Left side with it. Bergen. Bowen on her. Good pick up there by Smith. Back over now to Turner. Turner tries to curl. Back over now to Simmons. Simmons trying to get a handle on it. Puts it up. Just, oh, throws it up. A wing and a prayer, and it falls in. Her prayers are answered. We're going back the other way. 20 seconds left to play. A 5-point edge here in the third quarter. Here comes Payne. Stops at the elbow. Boom. In the face of Simmons. Wow. Bergen throws it up, but it's not enough, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers were down by 11 and have come roaring back to be down by three going into the fourth quarter, folks. Worth the price of the ticket. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View and M Panther Sports Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just a touch of a button, because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry, there, James left the music on. All right, we're back underway here, ladies and gentlemen. Here come the Bulldogs, up by three, 48-45 the score. Turner will have it and bring it back right side. Simmons now with the dribble drive, goes on the curl, puts it up, trying to draw the foul and get the Lady Panthers in foul trouble. But they can't do it. Finally joining us, junior Alaysia Davis.
Yep.
Kansas City, Missouri?
Kansas City.
One of the Kansas. Oh, man. What a dribble drive by Geraldine Smith, and a blocking foul called on Mitchell. Is that four on Mitchell? We'll see. Is it four on Mitchell? Yeah.
Is she in foul trouble?
That's going to be four fouls on Mitchell. She's going to have to take a seat, and Shakespeare will check back into the game. Alaysia Davis joining us now, junior student here at Prairie View University, a member of the Panther Sports Broadcast Team. Man, this is a really, really good game. I know you got here late, but, boy, the last few minutes that you've been here have really been exciting.
Yeah, I walked in, they hit a couple threes, so I'm like, okay.
Smith puts the first shot away. It's good. Davis was a member of the Panther Sports Broadcast Team last semester for football and volleyball. We welcome her back here for basketball season. Really excited. And you are the, now, what is your position at KPVU? Know? What do you do over there? What do you know?
I'm a segment producer. So I have my own team, and they do multimedia journalism. So they come to the games, they report on the games, and conduct post-game interviews with the players.
It's thrown away into the hands of Payne to Roberson for two! The Panthers go up by 149-48. Here comes Bergen on the dribble drive. Easy shot from Wilson. She'll put it back in. But the Panthers are battling here in the Baby Dome. Payne will get it. 50-49. 9 minutes left to play. Payne drops it in to Smith. Smith at the left elbow. Finds it at the top of the key. Off the backboard. It's good. The Panthers go up by one. 51-50. Bergen coming left side, working on Soders. Soders on her like some paint. Bergen coming left side, trying to get Shakespeare involved. Good block that time by Waddle. Now she has Waddle on the hip. Good job of fighting through the pick is Waddle. Here comes Turner. She'll shoot it up for three. Back of the iron, no. Smith will snatch it down. We'll go back the other way. Payne will slow it down for the Panthers.
Yes.
Payne coming left side. Stops, drops, kicks it back out. Wide open. Waddle puts it in. Hits the front of the iron. Smith gets it back. Puts it back up. She's fouled. No call. Smith tips it up. No call. She gets it back. Soders kicks it out to Payne. Thought about the three-pointer. Takes it from 15. Hits the side of the iron. No. Just steal my thunder there. Boy, that would have been a good one. It's Mitchell coming out. Coast to coast, puts it up off the glass. No! Mitchell gets it, and we're going back the other way. Mitchell did not, pardon me, Simmons, Charles, didn't wait for any help. Waddle has it on the left block. Has it knocked away, no foul. And we're going back the other way. Here comes Turner. Turner loses it. Oh, my God. Two turnovers in a row by the Bulldogs. And, oh, my goodness, this is getting fun, folks. Checking in for the Panthers, Bowen will come back in. Payne will get a breather. So you got Bowen, Smith, Waddle, Soders, and Roberson in for the Panthers. Bowen, right side. Smith's on fire. Brings it to the top of the key. Stops. Pushes it over now to Soders. Soders can't find the hole, and we're going back the other way. And Roberson stops the momentum with a foul. Soders just couldn't get enough arch on it that time. Wide open, good pass by Bowen. The Panthers, sometimes you got to be a little selfish there, AD,
yeah,
and shoot the ball yourself. Shakespeare will
they
take it out.
They do say follow your shot.
Shakespeare will take it out, gives it up to Turner. Here comes Turner down the right side. Soders makes up for it, steals it away, stays up, gives it to Robertson. Fonte! Wow! The Baby Dome is on fire! 53-50. The Panthers have come back in sheer fashion, ladies and gentlemen, on the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M. Man, what a play. I feel like Nelly. It's getting hot in here. Stick around. We'll be back with more.
Hey, John, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center. Charles Porter, Alasia Davis coming to you live courtside. Man, this is worth the price of the ticket. 53-50 to score. The Panthers have been down most of the game trailing, but have come roaring back to lead by three. 53-50, and another steal by the Panthers. Here comes Roberson. Roberson with the double pump. She's going to be fouled and go to the charity stripe. And now, AD, it seems like, well, Alasia, it seems like the Bulldogs are getting really rattled with that tenacious defense.
Yes, that defense is coming in clutch for us, definitely. That's like the third turnover in the past 2 minutes.
Three turnovers in the past 10 minutes. The largest run of the game, again, at 8 points. The Bulldogs now with 20 turnovers. 23 past their average of 17. First shot is away, it's good. 54-50. Now the Panthers just need to pour it on.
Yep, they can hold it down in these last 7 minutes.
Folks, don't touch that dial. Exciting men's action coming your way 20 minutes after this one. The Bulldogs are in town. The Panthers having it a little rough here in the conference. We'll talk about them here in a minute. Panthers down. And another steal by the Panthers. Robinson with an easy one. Lights are going out here in the Baby Dome, baby. 57-50. Mitchell has it left side, brings it in the corner. Here's that trapping defense again. They throw it away again. Bowen throws it away. Mitchell gets it back, puts it up, and stops the bleeding. No, she misses it. Soders comes down with the rebound. And the Panthers are all over the place, folks.
It's a lot of energy in this arena tonight.
22 rebounds to 24 rebounds. The Panthers by two. Getting most of the, oh, wide open is Waddle, that's easy. Yeah, caught him slipping. Now we're playing Panther basketball. Payne is gonna be inserted for some more Payne. Man, great defense is what has rattled these Alabama A&M Lady Bulldogs, man, and the Panthers are up now by 9, their largest lead of the game. And a foul on Roberson on the floor. The Panthers, that's 3 fouls. It's on the floor. They've got 2 more to give. Payne will check in. Bowen is checking out. Williams is checking in along with Payne. And now you'll have Payne and Williams running the point. You have Soders at the 3 and at the 4 and 5, Smith and Waddle respectively. Here we come around the right side. Turner trying to find the opening. Mitchell kicks it on the left side to Bergen. Bergen thought about the dribble drive on the baseline, backs it back out. Wilson has it at the top of the key. Right side, Nash spins, takes it to the top of the key from the free throw line and drains it. We'll see. Did she get it? They're going to look at it. Well, one official said shot clock violation. They're going to look at this one, folks. Folks, season tickets for exciting Panther sports are right around the corner, AD. Mm-hmm. Your parents are buying tickets, and they're not even here.
Right.
They're just
going
to buy tickets and give them away.
Well, they are coming in March, so
they're coming
fitting.
In March?
March Madness.
Oh, man, that's going to be great. So I'll get a chance to meet your folks. You got to call them and let them know you're back on Panther sports. We just love for our students to come and do well like you have done so well here in the past. We're so proud of you. You've got a little mentee back here that you can start getting ready for Panther sports. And, man, I'm just excited about the opportunity to work with you young people.
Yes.
5-12 left to play. The Panthers are up 59-50. Williams, the sophomore from Cooper City, Florida, is on the floor to run the point. Williams brings it left side to try to find Soders or Payne. She'll find a hole. She says, I'll take it. Yeah! Well, I stand corrected. Williams finds the hole with the dribble drive and penetration. These are the exact things that Coach Sandy Pugh talked about on Saturday night. Everything she said that we didn't do, we're doing it tonight. Turner throws it down low. Wilson gets it. Soders, yeah, pushed her in the back. And that'll stop the bleeding. 4:32 left to play here. The Panthers are up by 11, being down by as many as 11 in the contest. Lewis will check in for the Panthers. Want to send a shout out to Converse, Texas, to the Lewis family there. They're checking us out. Glad to be back on. Thanks a lot.
I like Turner. She got a lot of heart.
Here we go back. Inside. Quick pass into Wilson. Backs it in. No good. Wilson battling for the rebound with Waddle. Waddle will last touch it. And 20 seconds on the shot clock. 4:27 left to play. Again, we want to thank AD Goff for stopping by and talking to us earlier. Said he'll check back in with us. Does a great job of color commentary. Wide open for 3. Bergen shoots a big, huge air ball. Is that a double negative? Big and huge.
Too strong.
That a double negative?
Yeah, that's a double negative.
Okay, because Thetis will get me. Well, the gang's all here now, huh? Everybody's popping in today. Nash from 10. Off the mark. Lewis with another rebound. And here comes Payne. Now the Panthers really can kind of relax here.
Mm-hmm.
Don't slow down. Play some good heads-up basketball. Watch your passes. Don't fall. And let's close this one out. We're heading to 6-3. Keep your head in it. Down to 5 seconds on the shot clock. Payne's got to do something with it. Throws it over on the right side. Waddle just throws it up. Hits the back of the backboard. Bowen will check back in. Turner hobbles off for the Bulldogs, replaced by Shakespeare. And also, is that Nash checking back in? Well, Mitchell and Turner will check out. I know Shakespeare checked in. And yeah, it was Mitchell. Here we go back to the right side. Bergen over to Mitchell. Mitchell stops, puts it back up. Pardon me, Simmons. And she misses everything. Jada Roberson will come down. 11, that's Simmons. Bowen. Now slowing it down with 3:27 left to play. 16 on the shot clock. Roberson has it, brings it left side. He wants to do it again. Roberson out now to Bowen. Bowen with a run and jumper. Rolls out right there to put it back in. Is Lewis, who's playing that right block really well. Great block out that time on Shakespeare. Lewis almost with another steal. Here comes Simmons, and she puts it off the glass for two. The Panthers with 28 rebounds, out-rebounding the Bulldogs by four, 28-24 here.
No doubt about it, we have the faster run game.
I'm trying to find the fast break points. That is going to be the key, and then the points off turnovers is going to be the key statistic here tonight. Great defense by the Panthers. Payne with it now with 3 seconds. Puts it up from the right elbow. Ice water. Ice water. It's cold. Bergen steals it away. Well, Bowen, rather, steals it from Bergen. And, man, the Panthers just are all over the Bulldogs, just mauling them tonight. Rawr. Dixon will check in for the Panthers. Gets it now to Simmons. Simmons, man, on the fast break. Dribble drives. Takes it all the way down on the right side. And Shakespeare.
What I like about it, we're playing hard defense, but it's clean defense. Not that many fouls are being called, but we're getting a lot of turnovers.
I tell you what, the Panther fans are really showing up here.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is not even a TSU game. It's almost packed in here. When you bring the band over here, it's not going to be any seats. Shakespeare at the line drains the first one, 65-52. Bowen played some quality minutes off the bench, man. She was really the spark that really got the Panthers going off the bench, along with Waddle in the second quarter. 2:11 left to play. The Panthers seem to be in pretty good shape. First shot is away. It's good for Shakespeare. 65-53. The Panthers up 12. Math person?
65-53, Panthers up 12. That's
okay,
correct.
Okay, just checking. Second shot is away. No good. Snatched down by Wilson. And Wilson goes back up and is fouled that time by Williams. You got to get your hands straight up. You know, she's swatting at it. Put your hands straight up. And Shakespeare with some quality minutes will take a seat. Here comes Mitchell back up off the bench. Mitchell with some quality minutes for Coach Margaret Richards, the senior from Austin, Texas. Wilson's first shot is away. It is no good. 12 of 17 tonight for the Bulldogs. They're shooting now 70%, shot 90, shot 100% in the first quarter. 2 minutes left to play. Roberson across the timeline, and everybody's getting excited about it now. Payne throws it down now to Smith at the left elbow. Smith will black it out. Lewis wants it. No, she'll get it to Payne. Payne comes around the right side. Payne looking for the baseline. Puts it right inside. Over to Williams. Beautiful. No, it rolls off. But great disc there. Over to Williams. And a jump ball. It'll go down to the Bulldogs. But, man, great pass into Williams. She can't get frustrated, Alasia. She's got to stick with her game. She's a menacing force down there. And she's got to get her confidence back. Waddle's played the majority of the time tonight off the post. Dixon brings it right side over to Mitchell. Mitchell almost travels, gets it over to Anna Simmons from the free throw line. Puts it off the back of the iron, no good. Roberson gets the rebound, and here we go now with down to a minute and 18 seconds. Roberson will have it right side. folks are prepping you for the post game. I don't know if Coach Evans is going to come right over or if Sandy will, Coach Pugh, pardon me, will join us at the pregame of the men's show. We'll let you know here in a few seconds. Oh, Williams, come now. Williams with an intentional foul. Are they going to give her an intentional? She grabbed her arm, 44. That's three on Williams. You're going to have to sit down and have a chat with Williams. Just calm her down, man. She's got all the ability in the world. She can't get frustrated like that. Might need to give her one of those books you got. 53 seconds left to play. The Panthers, folks, in control, 65-54. They're going to put a couple of seconds back on the clock here. AD, exciting men's action coming your way. You'll be going back and forth getting some reports for us. You're reporting for KPV-TV?
KPVU-TV, yes, sir.
KPVU-TV, okay.
Yes.
KPTV sounds more cooler.
Oh my
get it more cooler, like more gooder, like as in
more better. Haberl,
there you go.
Right.
Haberl, Gummy Bears, whatever.
You been watching Madea?
Yeah. Oh, by the way, I want to send a shout out if they're watching now. I'm sure by the men's game, John Miller met a very, very nice gentleman yesterday who knew Luther Francis of Prairie View. We'll talk about it in a minute. Here we go, bringing down on the right side, down to 50 seconds left to play. Simmons shoots a long three-pointer. They give it back to it. Simmons will shoot it again. Give it to her twice, she'll hit it. 54, 57, 65. The Panthers now down with 42 seconds left. Payne's got to be fouled now. They're going to foul her immediately. And Simmons knocks it out of bounds. Payne loses it. And Coach Pugh almost loses it. Payne like, I got it, Coach. I got it, Coach. Just let me have it. Just give me the ball. I love it. Did you see that? She said, just give it to me.
Yes.
Just give it to me. I love it.
She plays with a lot of confidence for this to be her first year here at PV.
Well, she's a transfer from LSU.
Yes.
she can play. Mm-hmm. I mean, LSU was loaded, so G. Willikers, you know, how much time do you get? But she came here, and she's helping out the Panthers, and we're glad to have her. Kept the same colors. Here goes Smith at the top of the key. Down to 26 seconds left, about a 10-second differential. Panthers look like they have this one in hand. Here comes Bowen. Bowen loses it, and there's a mad scuffle for it. The possession arrow is down here on the Panther side. We'll see. The Bulldogs will take a timeout. We'll stay here doing this timeout, folks, and remind you about National Signing Day on February the 7th at the Southside Sports Club. 1110 West Airport in Stafford, Texas. If you need more information, you can always call 936-261-9100. 936-261-9100. You can go to our webpage at www.pvpanthers.com and find out all the information from right there at our marketplace. Get tickets. Just drop the drop-down box. Just go ahead and search the webpage. A lot of interesting things on the webpage. We kept some old-school stuff on there just to keep grounded. They got a lot of new information out there, man. I tell you, they did such a great job with our webpage. Miss Latanya Thurston, our boss. Well, I guess I can call her boss, even though I'm older than her.
Call me boss?
I call her boss, just for her.
Right.
No, she does a great job in getting us all prepared today. I tell you, this one, I was afraid everything was working on time. Everything was perfect all the way up until game time. AD came right on over, and we had no snafus. Man, I'm excited about what's going on. We're just growing and growing here in Panther Lane. 16 seconds left to play. Mitchell will get it in to Bergen. She'll put it up from 15. Then it'll creep in. Down to 11 seconds now. 59-65 to score. Another timeout by Richards. And down to 11 seconds. They're going to foul immediately. I get it into the hands of Payne or into the hands of Soders. She's a great free throw shooter. Mm-hmm. They might try to get it into the big, and Waddle shoots great free throws. I put Williams in there because Williams shoots great free throws, but we just don't want any more freshman mistakes. But we'll have a chat with her because I'm excited for Adriana Waddle and even more excited for Amari Williams. They're going to be a good tandem. Greek night here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. Don't forget, well, the big game of the year, our biggest game by far, basketball, this Saturday. Texas Southern comes to town. Tell us about being a student when TSU comes for basketball. Football is a whole other animal, and it's been great since we've been doing home for home, and I just love it.
Yes.
We'll talk about your studentship in a minute. Is that a word? 11.5 seconds left to play. Robertson to bring it in. All the way out now to Bowen. She's going to be fouled immediately. Bowen's a good free throw shooter. Oh, she's just playing keep away. Robertson keeps it away. Over now to Smith. Somebody's got a foul. They give it back over now to Lewis. That's it for him. They can't do anything with it. Great ball movement by the Panthers. That's what I'm talking about. Man. Now that's heads up basketball, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. The Panthers of Prairie View A&M defeat the Bulldogs of Alabama A&M to take their record to 4-3. I tell you, the goal is to be 6-3 at the end of this homestand, ladies and gentlemen, and the Panthers have just etched another notch. Stick around, folks. Exciting men's action coming your way. The Bulldogs are in town. We'll take a break and come back with the pregame show. Talk to head coach Sandy Pugh. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
Let me see where it is. Go ahead, shake some. Go ahead, shake some.